In this video, we will try to solve a problem on portal frame using flexibility matrix method. So this is the problem statement. Analyze the portal frame A, B, C, D as shown in figure. EI is constant. And here we have six supports at A and D. And columns A, B and C, D are having different lengths. And one horizontal force is acting at B. Then UDL over the entire span of BC. So here, in addition to in flexibility matrix method, first we have to convert the given determinate structure into indeterminate structures by removing redundant reactions. Therefore, first we have to identify the redundant reactions. For that, we have to calculate first this degree of static indeterminacy so that we can know the number of redundant reactions. So, the first step is primary structure, in which we will convert the given indeterminate structure into determinate structure by removing the redundant reactions. So to find out the redundant forces, first we have to calculate total number of reactions, which is equal to 3 at support A and 3 at support D. So totally 6. The number of equilibrium equations available for this structure is equal to 3. That means sigma h is equal to 0, sigma v is equal to 0, and sigma m is equal to 0. Therefore, degree of static indeterminacy is equal to r minus e, which is equal to 3. Therefore, we have to remove 3 reactions, redundant reactions, to make the given indeterminate structure into determinate structure. Therefore, we consider, I already told that in the previous lecture, as far as possible, we have to try to make the structure or the cantilever. Because in cantilever structure, the computation or the calculation will be much simpler than other kind of structure. Therefore, we make the support either A or D as free support. So in this problem, we choose the support D as our free support by removing or by considering all the reactions at support D as our redundant forces. Therefore, let RD, HD and MD be redundant forces. Therefore, the primary structure is, so this is our primary structure with the fixed support only at A, and at B we have 3 reactions now acting as external forces. So we make the support D as now the free end. Okay. Therefore, our system coordinates is number 1 along horizontal direction, that is Achdi, along the direction of Achdi. Number 2, along the direction of RD. Number 3, along the direction of MD. Now, the next step is to do our moment calculation. That means we have to calculate the moment due to external loads alone and moments due to unit loads acting separately at each system coordinate. Therefore, we will get small m1, small m2, small m3. So, this is the table for moment calculation, member, section or span, limit, capital M, that is moment due to external load, small m1, that is unit load is acting along the direction of system coordinate 1, small m2, the moment due to the unit load acting along the direction of system coordinate 2, small m3, the moment due to the unit load acting along the direction of system coordinate 3. So, we can now consider the CD member. So, this is the CD member. So, in this structure, we will have only external loads for the calculation of capital M. Okay. So, we have to draw a section in CD span and we are measuring the distance from the free end D. Therefore, limit is 0 meter at D and 2 meter at C. Therefore, 0 to 2. And capital M, we consider the right side of the section and there is no load. Therefore, capital M is equal to 0 for the member CD. Now, apply unit load along this direction, okay, along system coordinate to 1. And now take the moment because you are inside the frame. Therefore, this force, the unit load acting along system coordinate to 1 will develop a positive moment above this section xx. The distance is x. Therefore, the unit load value is equal to 1. Therefore, 1 into 6. Therefore, plus x. And the next m2, small m2, we have to apply unit load along the direction of RD or system coordinate 2. And this load is meeting at the section, therefore there is no moment due to this load, therefore 0. Again we apply unit moment along system coordinate 3. Okay, now take, this see this is a clockwise moment, okay. Therefore, the right side clockwise moment will be considered negative about section xx, therefore minus 1. Because the value of the unit moment is equal to 1, therefore minus 1. So next consider BC. So draw a section in BC. Now we are measuring distance from C point. Therefore, the limit of the BC member is at C we have 0 value, at B we have 4 meter value. Therefore, 0 to 4 is the limit of the section. Then capital M. Capital M is the moment due to external load. See, consider the right side of the section. Here we have a part of UDL. That load will come into capital M calculation. So, the intensity of the UDL is 30 and acting downward. Therefore, minus 30 into x by 2. Now, apply unit load at system coordinate 1 here. Okay, system coordinate 1 and the value of input is equal to 1. The distance between C and D is 2 meter and section is at x distance from C. Therefore, this is acting now in anticlockwise direction about xx section, therefore positive moment. Then the value of moment is equal to 2 because unit load is acting here, that is 1, and this load and the distance between this point, the section and the load will not change. Okay, even though the section x is moving from C to B, wherever the section is, the distance between this the load acting here and this point is always constant. That is the length of the CD. So length of the CD is equal to 2 meter. Therefore, 1 into 2 is equal to 2. Next, M2. So we have to apply load here, okay, at D along system coordinate 2. Then the distance between this force and x axis is nothing but this x. Therefore, 1 into x is also no developing positive moment. Therefore, plus x. And now apply unit movement at point D, clockwise movement. So this is the movement, already a movement, so no need to multiply any distance. Okay, we can take as it is movement, but we have to attach the sign, that's all. So the right side of the section we have a clockwise movement, that will be considered as negative as per the bending moment definition. Okay, sign convention. Therefore, minus 1. So now consider BA, this, okay, so draw a section. Here we measure the distance from V point. Remember, we always avoid considering the reactions that support A, because those are unknowns. Okay, that's why we avoid. Always we consider the movements towards the free end, that is right side of the section always. So now the limit x at B is equal to 0, x value at A is equal to 4 meter, therefore limit is 0 to 4. Now capital M, you have to consider all the forces on the right side of the section. Therefore, on the right side we have one UDL over BC and one point load acting at B. Therefore, the UDL intensity is 30 and it is acting downward, okay. Therefore, minus 30 into 4 the span into half the distance. Because the CG of the UDL is here, that point will not vary based on the position of the xx. Wherever the section xx on AB, the distance between the section point and the middle of the BC will not change. That's why it is constant 4. By okay? Clear? Okay. So 4 into 4 by 2. Okay. Next, due to the point load. Point load intensity is 50. Again, it is acting this clockwise direction of both xx. That will be considered as negative, therefore minus 50 into this distance. This distance is nothing but x, therefore minus 50x. Now small m1, just apply load here. Okay, just apply load here. 1. This is 2 meter. This is x meter. Okay, so 2, we are here. Okay, 2 into, this is 2 meter, okay, this is 2 meter, for example, see, these things we have to consider, okay, our load is here, okay, so, consider, for example, the xx, now here, I have drawn the xx, meeting this point D, okay. In that case, it will confuse you to get the value of this one. Therefore, either consider this xx below the D point or above D point. Either one you have to consider. Okay. Now, consider the xx is here, just above the D point. Okay, here. That means, again, still x distance from B. This is 2 meter, therefore section is here, point load is acting here, so the distance between point load and section is this one. So this is 2 meter already, this is x meter, therefore this is nothing but 2 minus x. Okay? Clear? and this force is, you know, this will make a positive moment. That's why plus, so 2 minus x. Clear? Similarly, here next M2, the load is acting here. Okay, load is acting here, and the distance between this load and this point is 4 meter. Wherever the section is in AB, the distance between this point, perpendicular point, and this point and D will be same, which is equal to 4 meter. So distance is constant. The value of the force is equal to 1. So 1 into 4, 4, and it is now making anti-clockwise force on the right side, say, of the section. Therefore, this is positive moment. Similarly, M3, we apply unit moment along system coordinate 3. So again, this is negative moment. Okay, on the right side, the clockwise moment is negative. Unit is 1. So once we have this data, moment calculation is over. The next step is to find out deflections due to external load and deflection due to unit load to formulate the force vector and the stiffness vector, stiffness as flexibility matrix. So deflections are due to loads. The general form is delta IL is equal to integral capital M small m I divided by EI into dx. This is general term. So, in order to find out the deflection at coordinate 1 due to external load, that means delta 1L is equal to integral capital M small m1 divided by EI into dx. Therefore, M and M1 are the products, therefore both should be non-zero values to be included in the calculation. And for CD member, capital M is equal to 0, therefore we can't consider that section. The remaining other two sections, spans, we can consider because both values are non-zero. Therefore, integral 1 by EI we can take outside. Okay, integral 0 to 4 minus 30 x squared by 2 and plus 2 into dx. Sorry, plus 1 into plus 2 dx. Plus 1 by EI again. Integral 0 to 4. Okay. So this is capital M, this is small m1. This is capital M, this is small m1. Okay. So we get delta 1L is equal to minus 373.33 divided by EI. So next we have to calculate the deflection at system coordinate 2 due to external load. Therefore, delta 2L is equal to capital integral of capital M small m to EA into dx, so which is equal to so minus 6400 by EA. So in this case also we have included only two spans, that is CB and BA or AB. Similarly, delta 3L is equal to integral of capital M small m3 divided by EI into dx. Therefore, delta 3L is equal to 1680 by EL. Next, we have to calculate the displacement coefficients to get the flexibility matrix by direct flexibility matrix approach. The general equation is small delta ij is equal to integral of small mi small mj divided by ei into dx. So for m1, all spans having non-zero values, therefore we have three tabs here, one for each span. This is CD, this is BC, this is AB. Therefore, delta 11 is equal to 24 divided by EL. Similarly, we can calculate other displacement coefficients. Therefore, delta 12 is equal to delta 21 is equal to 60 divided by EL. So, delta 13 is equal to delta 31 is equal to minus 10 divided by EA. Similarly, delta 22 is equal to 256 divided by 3 EA. So, delta 23 is equal to delta 32 is equal to minus 24 divided by EA. And delta 33 is equal to 10 divided by EA. Therefore, the flexibility matrix delta is equal to, so it is a square and a symmetric matrix. All diagonals are positive. Okay. So this is the delta 11, delta 12, delta 13, delta 21, delta 22, delta 23, delta 31, delta 32, delta 33. Next we use compatibility equations to solve the redundant forces. So this is the compatibility equation delta into P into capital delta. Therefore, P redundant force vector is equal to flexibility matrix inverse into the displacement vector. So along system coordinate 1 we have HD, along system coordinate 2 we have RD, along system coordinate 3 we have MD. So in that order we have to write in this matrix vector HD, RD, MD. So this is the displacement matrix inverse, and this is the flexibility matrix, and this is the displacement vector. So final displacement that along system coordinate 1 is 0. This is the displacement at system coordinate 1 due to external load. Okay, so this minus and this minus gets cancelled. Now finally we get plus sign. Here also along system coordinate 2 we have 0 final displacement, therefore 0 here. Along system coordinate 3 we have 0 rotation, ergo 0. So by solving this we get HD is equal to minus 53.33 kilonewton, RD is equal to 69.99 kilonewton, or 70 we can make it 70. And MD is equal to minus 53.33. So once we have the redundant reaction, then we can solve other reactions simply by using equilibrium equations alone. So the next step is force calculation. In force calculation we will use equilibrium equations like sigma V is equal to 0, sigma H is equal to 0, sigma M is equal to 0, because we have three reactions to be solved. So this is the entire diagram with redundant force. Okay. These are the pink color reactions are to be calculated, this external load. Therefore, just applying sigma V is equal to 0, Ra plus Rd is equal to 30 into 4. Rd is here nothing but 70 kilonewton. This is Rd. So 70 kilonewton, which is equal to 30 into 4. Therefore, Ra is equal to 50 kilonewton. So similarly, applying sigma H is equal to 0, HA plus 50 minus 53.33 is equal to 0. Or we can take this minus 53 into other side as well, plus 53.33. So HA is equal to 3.33 kilometer. Finally, we apply sigma MA is equal to 0 to get the value of MA. Here, grouping clockwise moments and anti-clockwise moments, we get MA is equal to 0. So, next we consider the free ball diagram of the columns so that we will get the joint moment MB and MC. So, this is the free ball diagram of AB. Here again, considering sigma M is equal to 0 or MB is equal to 0, we get the value of MB. Because at support A, moment is equal to 0, there is no support, and RA is acting through point B, therefore that RA will not develop any moment at point B. That's why that is not shown here. RA is not shown here. Therefore, MB is equal to 3.33 into 4, which is equal to 13.32 kilonewton meter. Similarly, consider the member CD, free ball diagram of CD. So again, applying sigma MC is equal to 0. We are getting MC value. Here I have specified MCD because this MC is acting over CD member, that's why MCD. So MCD is equal to minus 53.33 kilometer. That means the moment is acting actually in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, anti-clockwise direction, not in clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. So once you have all the data, you can start drawing the bending moment. First, draw the profile of the portal frame, and here for easy reference, I put all the moments at joints in appropriate manner. Here there is no moment, zero moment, but over AB we have calculated MB acting in clockwise direction. Therefore, not to be equilibrium, the joint B in equilibrium, there should be an equivalent but opposite moment in other number. Therefore, over BC we have 13.32 moment acting in anti-clockwise direction. Similarly, in CD we have calculated 53.33 in anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, over CB member, there should be an opposite moment. That means clockwise. Here we have anti-clockwise movement at sub 20. Now it is very easy to draw the bending moment diagram, okay, observing the sign. So this is the profile of the portal frame. Now specify the support movements. That means using sign convention. So here zero movement, here positive movement. Positive means clockwise movement, therefore joined by a straight line. Okay, we have a triangle distribution over AB. This is a support movement. This is 13.32. Again over BC, it's anti-clockwise, therefore again above the line BC here. Then at C joint we have clockwise, that means positive, that means again above. It's 53.3. Therefore, like this, joined by a straight line. So this will be the support moment over BC. Again CD, remember you are here, okay, inside the frame. So this is the anti-clockwise moment, therefore above the CD line here we have 53.33, then join this line. And at CD, at a D point we have anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise is below the CD line. So joined by a straight line, that will be your support over which we have to draw the simply supported beam, span beam, span bending beam. Okay, so here we have only UDL over BC, therefore parabolic distribution will have maximum 50 kN per meter at midspan. Okay, this is the bending moment diagram. It's a negative value here, negative, this is positive, negative, negative, this is positive. So this is the end of the lecture.